Talking with Georgia State volleyball coach, both indoor and outdoor, Tammy Audi. And this is going to be a great day because this is a day probably as much of the players, if not more, you've been really looking forward to finally getting this facility complete, open, and ready for use.
Yeah, absolutely. For the last, 3 years, we've been looking at this plan on paper and, you know, telling everybody it's going to be beautiful and having it kind of be in our minds, you know, just imagining it. And now to be standing out here, you know, with your toes in the sand, literally, it's wonderful. It's really, really neat that this campus can have a facility like this.
Certainly, this is an exciting day. The official ceremony, pouring of the sand, and you guys feel like you have a home now.
Yeah, for sure. It was really surreal to walk in and see all the people here so excited for the ceremony and everything.
Yeah, it's a lot nice not having to drive 15 minutes for courts when we have our own courts right here. It feels really awesome to bring our home court here. I mean, we're from Ohio, so we really don't have, like, beaches, so we have imported sand. But, I mean, it's really nice to bring a little bit of Ohio to Georgia.
As you can see behind us, the roster is fully stocked. Really, the last piece of the puzzle was the ceremony to officially anoint this as your home court and get the facility open. You've got everything else.
Yeah, absolutely. The 12 girls that we have, you know, they're all sand volleyball players, and they love it. We literally have to get them off of the court sometimes and you know, tell them, hey, you need a break. You know, so they love being out here. They love being in the sand.
It's been months of construction, but finally it's done, and you can walk around out here in bare feet.
I know. It feels great just to get your toes into the sand and know that the foundation of this sport is about to get on its way.
And how difficult or maybe easy was it to put together the inaugural schedule?
Well, you know, a little bit of both. We're definitely going to see some people a couple times just because of, you know, the region, and we're very thankful for being in the Southeast that we're pretty heavy with the schools that, you know, are having sand volleyball. But, you know, you're still trying to schedule so that, you know, you can make sure that you're seated right in the end of the year tournament.
November 2nd, actually, is our first play date, what we call it, with FSU. So that will be the first stop to a whole new adventure of this team.
Only 25 schools playing sand volleyball. Talk about where the sport is now and where you see it going in the next few years, because it seems like it's one of the faster growing sports in women's athletics in the NCAA.
You know, the neat part about it and the thing that tells me that it's growing so fast is that when we have girls come on campus for visits, they're not playing court volleyball anymore. They're actually only playing in the sand all year round. So that tells me that it's not gonna, you know, end up eventually being just a crossover sport for somebody that didn't necessarily get a scholarship or anything like that. There are girls that are practicing all year round. They're flying to different tournaments and they wanna be really good in the sand.
Indoor is more of a offensive game and all that stuff, but on the sand, it's more mental than anything. You have to know your opponent as well as you know yourself. You have to know, oh, what shots are they going to do so I can line my defense up this way.
It's a lot different than indoor. Obviously, you have 6 girls on the indoor court and then 2 girls out here, so it's a lot of work. So a lot of aspects are different when it comes to hitting, passing, setting, everything. So if you ask the difference between indoor and sand, it's a huge difference.
I feel like indoor, you have more of like a jolting of the knees and like thighs and all that stuff, and here it's just more strength and endurance.
The reaction is great. You know, we bring girls here and they think, okay, I'm on a downtown campus. We always just say we just need to get people here. You know, so then they come and they see the campus and they actually get to feel that we do have a campus feel here at Georgia State. They get to spend time with the girls, which is always a lot of fun. I know I'm a little biased, but we have great girls on campus. But then you bring them back here and you get to see, you know, the Gold Dome that we get to overlook. You know, we get them out here, they walk out here on the, you know, boardwalk, and they're just in awe because you feel like you're out here on a beach. You know, you don't have the ocean or anything like that, but you actually get to dip your toes in the sand. You get to walk on a boardwalk, and it's something that is here, you know, right next to the Science Center, right next to the gym, and then you get to have the Capitol overlook you. It's just a beautiful facility.
We're 4 hours from the ocean. We're nowhere near Savannah nor Florida. What's it like to see beach and sand in downtown Atlanta, right across from the MARTA station?
It's awesome. Everyone's like, when they talk about, oh, beach volleyball in Atlanta, they're like, where do you guys practice? And we're like, oh, we have our own court. They brought in the sand. It's going to be like our own little beach. And everyone's like, all right, that's cool. Can we come and like hang out? I'd be like, well, you got to come watch our games.